Hey folks, welcome back to Let's Play Grand Theft Auto 5 on the Mysterious JG. And although I wasted a bunch of money on a helicopter, a place to park helicopters that I don't own for Franklin, it does kind of seem like maybe we're going to be able to do this mission with Dom after all. Unless it's too dark. Like it's the wrong time of day for the mission to be available. Which would be annoying if that is the case. Yeah, it's not showing up anymore. But we should have this, Oh, there it is. It's back. Okay. All right, let's try to get back over to Dom's. I think it was, yeah, one of these buildings here was the one that Dom is on. Fuck! No! No! It's no good. I thought I was gonna be able to drop out without using the parachute at all. So, oops. Oh well. All right, guys, we're gonna spend like half of the video because I'm gonna load. I'm sorry. We're gonna load and we're gonna spend half of the video looking at the loading screen because I decided to crash into the side. Because what I did is crash into the side of the, Unknowing the truth? Autosave Minutemen Blues? Minutemen Blues. I think this is the one we want. Hopefully this doesn't. Yeah, because I think this will mean that we've. Autosave may have been me. I don't think the thing that we did for Maude with the bail jumper counted. So I think if they're called Minutemen Blues, but the manual save was the one after I turned in that guy. So what we might want to do is use Trevor to go over to try to find the Trevor Phillips Industries chopper and fly it over to Franklin's place and then switch characters and see if that would work. Otherwise, it is kind of a pain in the ass. Like, where do you get a helicopter to do Dom's mission? Because trying to get in there in an aircraft, I mean, we could do it again. It's much easier to steal a fixed-wing aircraft, it looks like. But then you have to paradrop onto it. And I'm almost positive whatever mission we're doing with Dom is going to involve paradropping off of the roof of that building. I don't know why you can't go into the building and get a ride up to the top in an elevator. I suppose if you're just a regular old dude, I don't know what Dom's deal is that, you know, he's paid someone off to have access, but you're just a regular person walking in off the street. You usually can't get rooftop access to a building like that. Those doors that lead out to the roof are usually locked. You know, amongst other reasons, to stop people from. Oh, a cinema Doppler. Meltdown. Capo Lavoro. In order to stop people from going up there and committing suicide, which can be kind of a big pain in the ass for buildings like that. It's a pretty spectacular death that Franklin had, but yeah, this is what's annoying about loading. You do like we dropped a couple hundred K on something that was going to be worthless to us, so it felt silly to me. Like I'll buy all that shit after we finished all of the assassination missions and know we've squeezed every penny out that we can get before winning the main story of the game. At which point, I don't plan to have left a bunch of stuff for us to do that involves money. I got a save file somewhere where like Michael has enough money to buy the golf course from waiting and not doing any of the stock market missions until after finishing the main story, which involves a big cash windfall for everyone. But this is why it's annoying to load, even if you just lost a bunch of money, because how long have we been staring at loading story mode 90% now? Me again, this old timer's one of them crazy anti-establishment types, lives outside the system in some kind of hobo camp, might look harmless, but watch yourself, he's... Got a couple of screws loose, all right.
Christmas has been a bad boy.
Well, there's a helicopter flying overhead, but... What's his name? Let's just do this. Curtis Weaver. If it wasn't for the weavers, so what would you do? I'm just gonna punch it straight into the, Dignity Village. I'm just gonna plug it straight into the search engine, not even... Curtis Weaver. How many are there? I guess there's only four and I got confused. All right, so Polito Bay, across the street from where the Pac-Man mission ends. Well, I don't know where the Pac-Man mission ends, IGN. What the fuck? A map. He said Dignity Village, Hobo Camp, and Polito Bay. Yeah, they don't show a damn map. All right, well. Let's see if somebody else has a more specific map, because I think this is how we're wrapping up these videos today. Some of you, like one of these guys, just show a damn map. There's a video walkthrough that probably does. Boy, I'm sitting here looking out a video walkthrough, but it's not loading. Can you just show the damn map? Okay, I got it. Okay, this is... And now my freaking laptop is acting weird. That was really odd. All right, so where we actually need to go is... Yeah. I moved away because that window was glitching out, but it's up here someplace. Like, seriously, I need to close this window. It's going to crash my browser. But now that I know this is the general location, I can probably look at the text again. Or the email. That's not that useful, is it? Oh, well. Yeah, I know that it's up there on, like, sort of the northernmost part of the map. And we can get up there and poke around, and if I can't find it, I can load up a page that hopefully won't start causing graphical glitches on my computer. Sadly, I don't know for sure. I know where the Trevor Phillips industry or enterprises or industries, whatever, helicopter sometimes spawns. But I can't, I don't like feel like I can promise that it will still be there. That if like I make Trevor fly it to where I think Franklin is. What's going on here?
I just need a ride.
Okay, let's give her a ride.
Hey, got room for one more?
We won't take her to the evil people camp either.
Can you take me to the top of Vinewood Hill by the sign? Thanks, this is so sweet of you. I was starting to think no one was going to stop. Short dress, boots, vulnerable but playful demeanor. What more does a girl have to do these days? You cast out this kind of bait, you'd expect at least a couple of old sharks to come sniffing.
That's a weird thing to be saying to a dude.
So long you came. Thank God.
I just kind of jumped right back into my dialogue.
Prime of my life.
Just promise me you're not going to wear my skin or imprison me in a crawl space for 20 years. Joke. Kind of. You're cool, right? Sorry, I'm coming down. I've been hurting like a biatch. Yesterday was a blizzard, man. I don't even remember getting out of bed, let alone going to bed. Good times.
Okay. And what's on top of the Vinewood Hills?
Is that some kind of trivia question?
He's a security guard at the broadcast tower right behind the famous Vinewood sign. He's been stressed out, really working long hours, so I thought I'd surprise the big lug. We haven't seen each other for like a week.
It's kind of sweet.
Maybe it's two. I don't know. Crazy how time flies.
That's kind of sweet for somebody who appears to be like totally fucked up on drugs.
Speak of the devil.
Maybe I should go to the altruist cult.
No, not like that. I'm pitching back into town. Yeah, I know what happened last time, but I'm pretty sure this guy is okay.
Listen, I just got in a car accident, but I am willing to completely rejoin my conversation with you.
I ran out of money, or I would have gotten a cab. Yes, all the thousand you gave me, what's the big deal? I said I'd pay you back. I'm sorry, okay? My phone was out of juice.
Doesn't sound like we're going to be finishing this journey to get her
friends at Sandy Shore. You know, Brianna or Susie.
One of those.
No, I haven't spoken to him in weeks. This is just some random guy, I swear. Calm down, babe. Look.
I think they're breaking up right now.
Are you talking to me?
Yes, tell him you're not a guy called Brian. You're just some random guy.
What if I'm a random guy named Brian?
What? Just shout it.
I'm just some random guy not called Brian.
Okay, maybe we should have brought her to the altruist cult.
Babe!
He's killed himself.
Sorry about that.
Do you still want to go up there? No.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how well do you think that went?
He'll be fine when I surprise him. Probably just having a bad day. He can never stay mad at me for long.
I'm super hot, you know?
He's the serious, responsible, pay your bills, save for the future type, and I'm the sexy, bohemian, go off for days and do X in the middle of the desert type.
Mm-hmm.
I'm young. I'm still exploring my mind.
Wait, what the hell happened there? So oh.
Who I am. He knows I'll come back. Do something really impressive
and tell everyone about it. Did we just lose this mission because... Yeah, at this point in the story... Oh, jeez. You need an adventure travel service
that
can take you to
the far reaches of the earth and... That was entirely your fault! You make me want a lobotomy!
Yeah, so we're not allowed to drive into... Oh, God. Alright, well, we're never going to find out what her deal was, because we're not allowed to drive into the city at this point. I don't think I ever explored what happens when you do. Like, random guys attack you, and she just got out of the car and ran away, because what happened is we crossed a threshold where we were getting into the city, which we're not allowed to do at this point in the story with Trevor and Michael, because we're supposed to be hiding from Madrazo's men. So, okay. I might look up on my own what the deal was with that one seemed like the game is trying to get you as Trevor to take her to the altruist cult because she's hanging around out and being a druggie and just whatever unwholesome stuff would make a typical video game player feel like she deserved that fate. But in fact, my intention was to bring her to a boyfriend, and I was just curious to see how that was all going to go, because he was obviously pretty unhappy. But, I don't know where that was going to go now, because she was talking like it was all going to work out. I'm curious where it was going to go. But before she could say, oh, never mind him, take me here instead, and just at some point end the little side bonusy mission. No, it's just like, oh, never mind. She gets out of the car and runs, and you get a system message saying you can't drive into the city. So I think that was not intended. So slow down so we don't get too close to the cop car ahead of us. And I guess we'll go back to what we were. Like, I'm not going to load. I'm not upset that we're not going to see the... Like, I guess I'm... I don't know. That was probably more interesting from gameplay experience than the intended outcome of that would have been. Trying to figure out how the hell to evade the cops here. Like, I don't want all that nonsense to start again. There we go. So, I don't know that we're getting up there to do this mission with Dom. That'll have to wait. Because I can't even engineer it. Like, we got 14 minutes left, and then I'm not doing another video tonight. So, I don't see how we get to the point, like, unless I just happen to find a helicopter sitting around where we drop this, bail bond victim person off. I'm pretty sure. Bust and squirt out the window. Well, your mother must be proud. But I don't feel like we're getting a helicopter, getting on top of the building, and finishing Dom's mission in this video. But we can't say that there wasn't some interesting content in this. That's just one of those random things that can happen in this game, I guess. Game wasn't really thinking about when they had, like, the game wasn't thinking through when they had her spawn and have her destination she wanted to go to being in the middle of, or rather not in the middle of, but just like far enough south into the city that it counted as being in the city. Like, she shouldn't have spawned if I wasn't going to be allowed to do the mission that way. I could have taken her to the altruist cult. But, and some of these, I don't know, like, there's a little bit of dialogue. It's mostly the person you picked up talking. So there those little spots where Trevor or Michael or, you know, Trevor popped in and said stuff. Michael or Franklin would have dialogue they could throw in there, too. Oh, my God. Sure, why not? Let's see if this one works better.
Okay, well, come on then. Got yourself into quite a pickle, haven't you, little lady?
Mm-hmm. And she pulls a gun.
So, I'm assuming hospital, right?
No! No hospitals! Can you take me to Sandy Shores? I got people there who can help me out.
Okay, well, that's not in the city.
Sandy Shores.
Oh, I think she's a possible heist partner.
We're virtually neighbors! I assume you've heard of Trevor Phillips Enterprises?
What? No, I don't think so.
You might want to pretend, lady, so I don't kill you.
No point introducing you to my friends in the mountains, the state you're in.
What? Which friends?
Oh, he's actually contemplating taking her up there.
Organization in desperate need of some young blood. Another time, perhaps.
Look, thanks for this. Another 20 seconds, I'd have had the cops all over me.
Yeah, I think she's a person you can take on future heists.
It's not worth it.
I'm helping a bleeding girl who won't go to hospital or the cops flee the scene of a dead body. I reckon I deserve some deets here, girlfriend.
Just a job that went wrong. Trust me. Don't want to know.
You know, I love this kind of thing.
Oh, come on. I love hearing about criminal bloopers. Makes me feel so much better about myself.
So you're in the game?
Yeah, it's time to play the game.
You know, it really pains me when people refer to my lifestyle choices as a...
Although I am literally a character in a game.
Look, we hit a pawn shop, okay? But it was a sting. Cops were waiting for us. Supposed to be an easy job, low risk, $20,000 each.
I was the driver.
And not a very good one.
Hey, I got us through three roadblocks. We had half of San Andreas law enforcement on our ass.
I didn't have infinite continues.
That son of a bitch hadn't pulled a blade on me at 100 miles per hour. Spun us off the road. You cross me, I hit you down. No second chances.
Sounds like you need to find a better crew.
Like any crew.
Considering I got two in custody and the other one dead on the side of Sonora Freeway, I need any crew, period. Why? You know someone?
Mm-hmm.
Maybe you should do something about that pile of blood and guts pouring out of you.
You know someone? I got a real tomboy voice.
They got nothing to connect me. No real names, no addresses. Left all the money. Way too hot to wash. I'll get myself patched up. Lie low at the safe house for a day or two, then see what I can put together. That bastard stuck me good.
What if you're dead already, and this is your first taste of hell? Dwell on that.
Anyway, I'll leave you with my friend, Chef. The year's most innovative new touches, Chef.
Listen, I ain't sure what you're into, but you need a driver anytime, you let me know.
My voice really carries, even as I walk away from you while bleeding. We got now Taliana Martinez unlocked as a new Heist member. Now we just cannot get to this frickin', I guess we haven't explored Sandy Shores enough. We cannot get to this location without unlocking a bunch of distractors. So we're gonna take one more shot at this, and if we don't get up there this time before something happens, then I guess we are not doing the Dom mission or the bounty hunter mission in this video. It's an entire video of being distracted by people on the side of the road. But only in Grand Theft Auto World would you meet somebody who was a getaway driver who just needs a... I caught myself being distracted by whatever that sign was on the left back there. But you just rescue a getaway driver, and then like later in the game you could be like, oh, we should use this person who I know for a fact crashed their getaway car. Although she says it was because one of the guys in her crew stabbed her, presumably trying to get her part of the take, but I don't know. I guess it wasn't a particularly good crew she was with after all. We're not even at full health because one of the Mariazzo whatever thugs who chased away our little friend that we were trying to get to. Now, I wonder if that lady will show up later. It's like, take me to the top of the Vinewood sign and just act like the whole first half of that conversation never happened. I also just had this brief moment where I thought, hey, like, was that me blinking at an odd time or was there a flash and there's another distractor mission coming up? It's even just doing this one thing. This bounty hunter thing is going to, I believe at this point, cause us to be a little on the late side.
Screw you, Frankie.
Oh, this has got to be it. Yeah, Dignity Village. This is it. This is the homeless camp. Capitalism is what? How dare you? Is crud? CRDD? Crisis. Okay. Boy, these RPGs that I've been playing the last year or two certainly do love homeless camps. Revolution will not be televised. Another world is possible. I just hope the truck hasn't already disappeared. Remember thinking this guy's a bit of an anti-climax. Like, he's not that tough to catch, if I remember right. We're the poor, the unemployed, in debt, fed up. Home for all.
You're coming with me, sunshine.
Oh.
Goddamn bounty hunter. I knew it.
Yeah, somebody had a gun.
You're a slave to the system.
All right, so he's decided to run into...
This is discrimination.
Well, do you have the gun? Somebody had a gun. Ah, crap.
I have the right to defend myself.
I think he just fired off his only bullet at, like, one of his fellow homeless guys. Ah, boy, this is... Fuck you, I won't do what you tell me! I want to get the, okay, like, why am I not being allowed to run? As fast as this old guy is. I just want to get him before he gets out on the road and gets himself run over. Because I want to see the dialogue that you get with him.
You're a slave to the system.
Man. Okay.
Okay, that's enough. You got me.
All right.
Oh, that's better. Now let's go before I change my mind on the whole dead or alive
thing. Mm-hmm. All right, so we do... need to... I'm not going to bother to try to get our vehicle back. So we are going to need to steal a vehicle. And luckily, they are quite willing to hop with you into stolen vehicles, as we've seen repeatedly.
Is this
it? It now!
Stop pretending to be countercultural.
I'm not. I'm just... I guess he thinks stealing a car would be countercultural. Hopefully we don't run into anybody who wants a ride to a safe house.
Can you play nice now, Granddad?
I'd rather die fighting than surrender to the hypocritical laws of your oppressive regime.
Okay.
Although you did, in fact, surrender.
Well, I after got tased.
I took a stance, didn't I? Stared the bully in the face, then back down at the last minute. That's how activism works. Not that I'd expect a mindless drone of a nanny state like you to understand.
We need more missions like this where this guy insults us.
So well armed.
I'm not a hobo. I've made a conscious decision to reject the capitalist society.
So you're hobo.
Living in a hobo camp.
It's a lifestyle choice, you government stooge. And have you looked in the mirror recently?
Mm-hmm. We do have a kind of hobo-ish look about us, don't we? We have a certain hobosity, an air of hoboism.
This discrimination disgusts me. I only just got out of jail for that sitting protest outside the exchange in Liberty City. Mm-hmm. Such a sense of the power of group action until we all turn around.
What are they trying to send you down for now? I didn't pay much attention to your file.
Of course you didn't. I assaulted a cop at an anti-globalization rally, beat him up with a fire extinguisher.
Oh, cool.
And I'd do it again. Screw the police.
Don't you mean fuck the police?
Mindless stoolies of the totalitarian regime.
You're preaching to the choir, Pops.
But then, are we going to let him go?
A paid thug of a corrupt legal system rounding up agitators for the ruling autocracy?
Yeah,
a puppet on a power trip. I just wonder who's got their hand up your ass.
It's Maude.
Whoa! Hold on there, socialist Santa. If you want an anarchy off, I will take you down any day. I wreak indiscriminate mayhem on an hourly basis. Mm-hmm. And secondly, no one has a hand up my ass. Would you like to look? Listen, nobody's more anti-establishment than me, old man.
Well, then let's team up.
So watch tone.
Oh, I'm sorry. Hired mensch of the dictatorship. Did Daddy not
Mench?
Love you?
No. Daddy left me at a shopping mall and never came back, so I burnt it to the ground.
A little pain you're working through there, eh, Trevor?
I've killed in just the last week, and I am very happy to add your name to the pile right now. So why don't you shut your mouth?
Okay. Leave it there. Touch your center, Lacey. Why are we stopped? Is this the part?
Because I'm trying to hear the dialogue. The road? Yeah, that was tempting there. But I think this is it for these missions.
Well, if it isn't my dear old buddy Trevor.
And my favorite guy with
hello, Maude.
Fuzzy ear warmers.
I kind of look upon you as the friend I never had, the son I never wanted, and the shrink I could never afford.
You do?
Kinda. The pursuit of criminal men for profit is backbreaking.
Yeah, you look really tired.
Soul-crushing work. Oh,
I can only imagine.
I'm retiring, Trevor. I want a peaceful life, away from all this insanity and degradation.
At Bishop's.
I want a picket fence, and a husband, and a dog named Skip. I want the dream, Trevor, and I won't let anyone stand in my way.
And she kills you.
Good for you, Maude. I wish you well on that quest.
I'll find it, Trevor. I'll find it all. I'm a passionate woman. Goodbye, my boy.
Goodbye, Maude. Be well.
So, yeah, I guess that was funny. I do know that we're going to steal her truck, for one thing. Good luck with your quest. I'm stealing your truck. I guess she pops up in the... She doesn't mind that we stole her truck. She does have some final dialogue for us there. But yeah, she shows up again in online, where I guess you just the quests that she gives you are just generically opened by a message saying that she could not stay away from the quest for justice, and you just get emails from her that are not even voice acted, sadly. So that's kind of it for Maude. I haven't played any GTA on online. I mentioned having like people in Grimmett's Discord talking about how it's this horrible money-sucking thing. It seems to me like a lot of people seem to get a lot of enjoyment out of it for a long time. I can't imagine like the GTA games are huge. But the development times are insane. Like, I don't know how much money GTA 5 made just without the, without that aspect, the online play. And then I don't know what any competitor who doesn't have the Rockstar name to trade on, like, how can they spend Rockstar budget developing a game? Because it would have to be, like, a crazy bestseller for anybody. I don't know. Game development seems like a pretty dangerous thing to be going into to make money. But... what the hell do I know? I know that I'm calling it a video. I know that we didn't get that Dom mission done. And now I am kind of remembering, yeah. I'm kind of remembering that part of the reason I hate Dom is the whole trying to get his... I think this is the last mission we do for with him. But I do remember now needing a helicopter to get it being a bit of a stumbling block. I'm sure we'll get it eventually, folks, but I'm not too worried about getting it right now. When we come back next time, maybe we'll go and do that mission for Dom straight away, or maybe we'll get back to the story. Maybe I'll even do the last couple of assassination missions before I can spend Franklin's money buying places to store the helicopters he doesn't own. Whatever we do next time, you'll find out about it next time. Bye-bye.